this, but right now we've got Martha Hall Findlay starting her presentation. Let's listen.
Desire to step up and try and make a difference.
I look into the window of my mind.
We want to be proud of us as Canadians. We want to be proud of Canada.
Of the fears I know
what one believes one can accomplish in politics.
I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending.
Our challenge as a party is that we can't just keep saying things and hope that our fortunes will change. We have to prove it.
What have you done today to make you feel proud? It's never too late to try. What have you done today to make you feel proud? Mm-hmm. You could be so many.
I look at this country, and instead of the Harper vision of, you know, how much less can we do, how much narrower can we be, how much more pinched can we be, it is, I'm a liberal, how much more can we do? How much more can we do as a country? How much more can we do as Canadians for each other, for our country?
She understands what the typical Canadian voter wants and what they need in order to make a successful Canada.
We can actually do more. We can do better for this country. We can make Canada a better leader in the world.
She's a bold leader, a bold individual who's not afraid to talk about the things that Canadians want to hear about.
We need courage in the Liberal Party. We need to stand for what we believe.
Qui offre le vrai alternatif. Et pour ça, on a besoin de leadership qui est empreint de substance, d'expérience, d'intelligence et de courage. De courage d'être libéraux ensemble. That's what we need in this country.
Party of economic responsibility, of fiscal prudence, but also of social justice, of equal opportunity, of environmental sustainability. That's what we are as Liberals. And we have to be confident because I can tell you I sure am.
My name is Martha Hall Findlay. And I will be your underdog this afternoon. But as my friend just pointed out, 45 years ago tonight, the Liberal Party actually elected the underdog. Here I am proud to be a member of the Liberal Party of Canada. Je suis fière d'être membre du parti.
I'm proud to be a member of the Liberal Party of Canada, and I am proud of being a candidate for its leadership.
To be a candidate for the leadership of this great party. The Liberal Party has had a remarkable past, and I want to lead this party to a remarkable future. And we, you, hold that future in your hands. Right from the start of this campaign, given all the hype in the media, so many people said, why bother? Well, when you care this much about this country, when you care so much about this Liberal Party and what it can and should do for Canada, you bother. And I say this to all of the volunteers, donors, and supporters, wonderful people all across the country. They all know how important it is to step up, even if it's against the odds. Sometimes, indeed, because it's against the odds. Thank you to all of you, from me, from the party, and from this country, for stepping up. Thank you for your help, your support, your dedication, and your friendship. Un grand, grand...
Many, many thanks to you.
I also want to thank my fellow candidates. We share a belief that we can make a difference in the Liberal Party, and that the Liberal Party can, once again, make a difference in the lives of Canadians. In a cynical time, we believe the things that we do in public life can improve the well-being of Canadians, protect and grow our country, and help families to prosper. I am proud to have walked this road with you. And even though some of us have disagreed on certain issues, I am inspired by your talent, your intelligence, and your commitment to the party we believe in and to the country we love. And thank you finally to all of my family, many of whom are here, including my three kids, Katie, Everett, and Patrick. Sorry, my place is such a mess, guys. Where's Mark Garneau and his vacuum when you need them? Seriously, thank you for always being there for me. Love you. Once more, I've had the opportunity to travel our great land. This time, with the added je ne sais quoi of being on the road through the 30 belows of winter. And all I can say is, thank God for long johns. Or, as evidence of my nonpartisanship, thank heavens for Stanfields. I have met so many inspiring Canadians. J'ai visité tant de municipalités et de...
I've visited so many cities and towns.
In fact, I believe our record was 8 different Tim Hortons locations in one day on PEI. I could make a joke about, anyway, well, too much coffee. To all of the many Canadians who took the time to tell me their stories, to better my understanding of their hopes and dreams, to share their wisdom and improve my ideas, I thank you. So, for all of you here, and for all of you watching, I have a question. As a party, as Liberals, where did our confidence go? The Liberal Party we once knew, of bold and brave ideas, brought us health care and the Canada Pension Plan, old age security, our flag, peacekeeping, and international respect. I mean, we're the party of both Lester Pearson and Romeo Dallaire. We were also the party of economic responsibility and fiscal prudence. We eliminated deficits, brought in consecutive surpluses, and paid down debt. Yes, the party of both
Jean Chrétien, and Paul Martin. We were the party of Kyoto, of the Kelowna Accord, of same-sex marriage, of saying no to invading Iraq. We were the party that not only believed but acted on the principles that economic prosperity is key and that our prosperity must have purpose. I want that party back. But how will we get it back? Do you know where our party will stand in 2015? Well, this is why your decision, your vote for our next leader is so critical for this great party and our country. Oui, vous avez des choix. Yes?
Yes, you have choices.
You could, conceivably, vote for me because of my new hairstyle. Or this killer dress. Canadian designed. But I ask you to vote for me because of my ideas and because of what I know we can do together. You know where I stand on many issues. I have never shied away from giving straight, substantive answers to any policy questions. You know that a vote for me is a vote for my clear vision for economic success, prosperity, and fiscal prudence, for environmental sustainability, for social justice and equal opportunity, and for thoughtful, engaged international diplomacy.
You know where I stand on many issues. I never shied away from giving straight, substantive answers to any policy questions. You know that a vote for me is a vote for my clear vision for economic success, prosperity and fiscal prudence, environmental sustainability, social justice, and equal opportunity, and thoughtful, engaged international diplomacy.
I've heard from some that the Liberal Party needs to do politics differently. I agree. But for me, it's not a catchphrase. Doing politics differently means something very specific. I have been clear for years now in advocating for that critical combination, principles and policies that are not right, not left, but the best ones together to take Canada forward. Depuis des années maintenant, j'ai été claire.
For years now, I have been clear in advocating for that critical combination, principles and policies that are not right, not left, but the best ones together to take Canada forward.
No longer fall back on policies simply because they are safe. We can no longer feel as though we need to please everyone. We must be bold and choose policies because they are the right ones for Canadians. Yes. And yes, that means sometimes being willing to challenge some sacred cows. Nous devons être prêts à questionner.
We must be sometimes willing to challenge some sacred cows to give to get back the bold and decisive Liberal parties that we must present to Canadians in 2015.
Has been plenty bold before. Being bold, being willing to step forward and to do what's right, sometimes against the prevailing wind, has in fact defined the Liberal Party's best moments and all that we have accomplished in the past for Canada. That bold approach is what we need again now. Les Canadiens recherchent un leadership dans...
Canadians want leadership they can trust to make difficult decisions when difficult decisions need to be made.
Canadians are not looking for a leader with whom they agree on everything. They are looking for leadership they trust to make tough decisions when tough decisions need to be made. Now,
thank you.
to win in 2015. Nous voulons gagner.
We want to win in 2015.
There are no silver bullets. Let's face it, Stephen Harper hasn't won three elections because he's such a charming guy. And it sure ain't because of his charisma. He focused on the economy. He proposed clear and specific plans. Not the right ones, mind you, but clear plans that focused on key issues that resonated with Canadians. So to win in 2015, we have a job to do. That's for sure. So let me just ask, how many of you have worked on campaigns, making phone calls, stuffing envelopes, banging in lawn signs, knocking on doors? How many of you have done that? Yes. Yes. And just by the way, how many of you have noticed, as I have, that the really grumpy people always turn out to be the Conservatives? Anyway, let's fast forward to October 2015. The election campaign is in full swing, and I hope you're all back out helping. The economy, as usual, is the most important issue to Canadians, but there is so much more. So it's mid-campaign 2015, picture yourself knocking on a door in Markham, Ontario. It's opened by Sam, a proprietor of a small business. Well, you want Sam to know that we have a leader who is business conscious, market oriented, and leading a party he can trust to manage our economy and run this country well. Imaginez-vous en 2015, vous faites...
Picture yourself in 2015. You are knocking on doors in Montreal. Yvette gets the door and tells you that she's concerned with the international role and reputation of Canada. Clearly, if Yvette wants to know that we have a leader who can discuss the challenges of the Eurozone crisis with Angela Merkel, someone who can deal with Vladimir Putin on Arctic sovereignty, someone who can work with Barack Obama to advance on North America's economic and environmental issues.
Yvette answers the door and says she's concerned about Canada's role and reputation internationally. Yvette clearly wants a leader who can discuss the challenges of the Eurozone crisis with Angela Merkel, someone who can face Vladimir Putin over Arctic sovereignty, and someone who can work with Barack Obama on making real progress on the economic and environmental issues facing North America. Now, imagine you're knocking on a door in Calgary Center, a riding we recently almost won. And young Paul asks about how to reconcile the oil sands and the environment. Well, you want Paul to see the Liberal Party as the only party that clearly understands the importance of our energy resources to our national prosperity, at the same time as knowing, as recent events are proving, that protecting our environment is in fact critical to our economic prosperity. They must go hand in hand. Now you're in Fredericton, knocking on the door. Suzanne answers the door but says she can't speak long because while she's getting supper for the kids, she's also tending to her aging mother who's just moved in with them. You want to be able to tell her that including home care and more elderly care in our healthcare system and pharmacare is a key part of the Liberal Party's platform. I don't need to tell you this. You know what it's like in the middle of a campaign. You know that all-important reaction at the door. These are real Canadians. Canadians looking for solutions to their problems and their concerns. The Liberal Party that I will lead will be there for Sam, Yvette, Paul, Suzanne, her mother, and the many, many Canadians looking for a change, for a new and much, much better government in 2015. But just a sec. My virtual campaign 2015 isn't quite over. Let me ask you to picture one more scene. the all-important debate. Up on the stage are Stephen Harper, Thomas Mulcair, and you know that we will need someone on that stage who is experienced, clear, firm, decisive, no nonsense, and tough. Friends, fellow Liberals, chers amis, chers libéraux.
Friends, fellow Liberals,
nous regardent.
Canadians are looking, are watching.
Watching. In the weeks and the months to come, Canadians will be judging us, assessing our new leader, determining for themselves whether she or he has the stuff to be Prime Minister. Substantive, experienced, bold, tough, that's the kind of leadership I'll bring. The Liberal Party that I will lead, clearly and decisively, together with all of you, will not be right, it won't be left. It will always be asking, what more can we do? How much better can we be? Que pouvons-nous faire de plus? Comment?
What more can we do? How better can we be?
In my head, and I know in my heart, that with the right leader and the right plan, we will bring our Liberal Party back. That Liberal Party of bold ideas, of optimism, commitment, enthusiasm, and that unshakable belief in what we can do together as Liberals and as Canadians. So I ask for your support. I ask for your vote. And then I will ask that you join me in taking back the country we love. Thank you very much. Merci.